We're living in the most crucial time in history, and it's not just about saying that, it's about showcasing how and what somebody can do nowadays to get ahead.
Everybody, it's Rob Keynes of GoldSilverPros.com, and I have two guests back on the program with me. You might recognize them from our conference, the Money Mental Summit we have back in August. They're back to join us to talk about the movie The Money Game that we're helping them to produce and why we're doing it. So as you guys know, a large part of our channel is to educate people on the markets and to help people navigate this complex financial system. And I think the movie that Julian and Chris are putting together is going to be fantastic for educating people on how that actually works and removing some of the mystique and the complication from finance and telling it in a way that average people will be able to identify with. So welcome, gentlemen, to the program.
Thanks, Rob. It's nice to be here.
Yeah, thanks for having us again.
So Chris Glazio came to me a few months ago. He's a money manager and came to me with this idea to talk about our complex financial markets in a way that everybody could understand and putting it in a format that people would identify with. And Chris, I know that you have shared with me a concept about financialization of the economy and how that actually works. So I'm going to share something that you put together for us that we talked about at the New Orleans Investment Conference. And that is the wealth effect. So maybe you can navigate us through this. What does this actually mean and how does it work?
So it's very simple. You can see the value of a $1 annuity. As interest rates fall, asset prices go up. When interest rates go negative, all assets are worth infinite. We're at a time, we're in the first time in human history that there's negative interest rates. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to timestamp a very important time in history that's never happened in human history. And so what you're seeing it throughout financial markets. You're seeing all these craziness in markets. You're seeing Dogecoin. You're seeing Amazon trading at crazy valuations. You're seeing,
Tesla at $1 trillion market cap when the last 3 or 4 years, they're net even on profits.
Actually, over the last four quarters, they lost, I think it was $2.6 billion. If you include stock options, trades at $1.6 trillion.
Yeah.
To make it more plain and more simple, there's a deli in New Jersey, the ticker is HWIN, that trades at $114 million. They sell $5,000 worth of pastrami and potato chips. And by the way, the point from the wealth effect, as interest rates fall go negative, all assets are worth infinite. The problem is that the system starts to misallocate resources. So the theme of our movie is capitalism requires risk to allocate scarce resources. When interest rates go negative, all assets are infinite, but the system starts misallocating resources. So our movie is basically trying to show how, through the eyes of an average American, how the entire system is broken and misallocating resources.
And what the average American can do to navigate through the system so they can thrive and succeed.
Yeah, let's talk a little bit about, let's break this down just a little bit. So I'm going to come off the share. When we're talking about negative interest rates, we're talking about the interest rate that the central bank is putting out minus inflation, and we're talking about real negative interest rates, not the stated interest rate that you get if you're going to go buy the 10-year treasury. Negative interest rates is a difference between what you can earn versus what you're losing in terms of devaluation of the dollar, right, Chris?
That's exactly right. So it's actually interesting. So you're talking about it from a real sense. So right now, if you believe inflation numbers from the government, inflation is 6.2%, but bonds are 1.5%.
Yeah.
So there's a negative 5% real return. But actually, shockingly, there was $17 trillion in bonds globally that have a negative yield in nominal terms.
Yeah, in stated terms on the bond covenants, right? So essentially what's happening is become risk-free for people to take on debt. And it's that debt and it's that over-financialization of the system, which has caused these paper asset prices to rise. And we're no longer in the land of value investing with Benjamin Graham and Warren Buffett. We're in the land of fantasy land as long as we can incentivize people to take on that debt, asset prices can continue to rise. And that's basically what we're seeing.
And the problem with that, though, is you notice productivity growth was negative 6.2%.
Right.
So the more asset prices go up, the slower the real economy grows.
And so that's what we're talking about with the movie. So I wanted to turn over to you, Julian, and talk about that. It's a very complex subject that we try our best on our channel to break down for people. And a lot of people do. Honestly, it's very complex, though. How are you guys going to talk about these concepts in a way that the average person really is going to understand what's going on?
Well, for one, unlike, plays or books, movies are less about talking and more about showing. So one of the beautiful things we can do with this art form is really show these important themes and really important information cinematically, so people can not only retain it but understand it from a much more visual means than just, you know, definitions. This is, we're living in the most crucial time in history, and it's not just about saying that, it's about showcasing how and what somebody can do nowadays to get ahead and to, again, thrive in this wild historical time.
So if you think about the way we're describing it is this, think about it simply, removing risk from a system changes the ecosystem. If you remove the lions from Africa, the gazelle population would explode, but then you'd be competing for scarce water resources and the entire system would die off. And that's actually what we're seeing right now. The Fed controlled rates, they changed the ecosystem. And think about the ways they changed the ecosystem. When I started in the business 30 years ago, you know, the majority of the market was active managers. Now 60% of the market is passive and 25% is quant. Yes. So we have 85% of the market that no longer looks at fundamentals. So, right. But there's a problem with that. It's fine. It's certainly, when you control one risk, interest rates, you're going to make sure the stocks don't go down, but you create another risk, which is inflation. If you remove the lions from Africa, you're not going to get eaten by a lion, but you're going to be the whole system is going to be competing for scarce water resources and die off. And so those are the parallels we're trying to draw.
And so one of the beautiful things about, again, the medium of filmmaking is each scene, we're going to be showcasing this in the real world happening today. Each scene, we're going to be able to really showcase what Chris has just, you know, verbally said, mm-hmm. so people can see what that means.
I'm being very visual myself. When I see an image on screen and it's got a concept behind it, that's how I absorb and understand the information. And I think a lot of people are visual learners as well. And I think that's why movies have been so powerful. You know, I took a film class in college, and the premise of the film class was that the moving picture really influences culture and in some ways can even be used to drive culture. And it's such a powerful medium. And really, I think when it goes back to Julian and Chris is the power of storytelling. I mean, for centuries, many cultures have passed down their traditions and their culture and their value system through stories. And really, modern film is just, you know, another version of that for people, you know, to experience together. I wanted to talk about, Julian, some of the projects you worked on before. So you provided us with a video here. So we're going to play that one. And we're going to walk through some of the successes that you guys have had and some of the projects that you've worked on. So that's really interesting. You know, there are a lot of popular movies, you know, I've seen recently at the movies that are there. Explain how you're going to bring some experience, Julian, with the projects that you've worked on to The Money Game and how that's going to enhance, you know, the quality of what you're producing.
Right. Well, one of the big things to be aware of is, you know, films are shot at all different calibers. And it's good, mm-hmm. I personally believe, to work on films that are done for, say, no budget or a scenario like Free Guy, which was done for over $150 million. It's good to be able to see what each budget can afford, what cost comes with each budget, and understanding that even on a huge nine-figure budget, there's still going to be a lot of different obstacles or things that might come up on the day that everyone has to creatively, on the spot, just find a way to make it work. And one of the things I feel very blessed personally in is being able to be on the front grounds and be able to see certain issues that occur, again, with all different budgets, and being able to be part of the solutions for what need to happen so we can move forward. Because one of the beautiful things about the film industry is it's a daily art, but it's also a grind, because as much as I love nature and the sun every day, that's one of the races. We race with the sun. And it's a beautiful, you know, fun, heart racing dynamic. But again, there's a lot of different components that you just got to always be ready for and be prepared and have a plan A through Z with everything.
Yeah, having been fortunate to grow up with a daughter who's in the industry, she's now filming Big Sky for ABC. She's been on Walker and the Walking Dead franchise, and been in a couple of independent movies that we shot out here in the States. You know, I got to see that process, and it's a wonderful, a very creative, but a very chaotic process. There's so much that goes on just to show you the images that you see on the screen and the hundreds of people on set just to produce content daily. It's wonderfully complex. And to have a successful production really takes the effort of a lot of people, and it takes a lot of experience. And that's one of the reasons I got excited about this project, Julian, is because I think that you have the experience, your team has the experience to put this together. This is not, you know, an indie flick or anything like that, where, you know, you guys are working in from a limited budget. You're bringing to bear all of these resources. So that's one of the reasons I'm excited for it. Talk about, you know, I want both of you to talk about your passion for the project. Because when you came to me, what stood out, especially when I met Chris, was just passion for this project. What drives, you know, your need to produce this movie? Because certainly you could work on any project you want. You could go do a Marvel movie. You know, you could go work on some other things that are really popular right now. But why Money Game? Why do you care about this?
For me personally, I'm just going to say I'm at a point in my life that I really want to do stuff that not only do I find entertaining in the moment, but I would love to produce content that has an impact and can actually in some way help the society we live in. And I really feel that this movie, as much as I want to personally see the final product, I really feel that it's for everyone. And it's a really important, entertaining thrill ride that can help a lot of people, or at least give them a fun time to see how one can navigate, you know, this day and age, and how they basically can make something and succeed. And I really, you know, with Money Game and with all projects I do moving forward, I want it to have an impact, not only positively for America, but ideally globally.
And for me, I really saw the ecosystem of capitalism has changed. Mm-hmm. Our real economy hasn't grown for years. I'm not sure what we have right now is capitalism. The theme of the movie is capitalism requires risk to allocate scarce resources. When the Fed started intervening in markets, you saw stocks go up, but you saw the real economy slow. And I think it's even more evident now than it's ever been in the past. So capitalism benefits everyone. Right now, notice that only the top 1% make all the money.
That's right.
All the money is flowing to the top 1%. Why? Because their stocks are worth infinite. Mm-hmm. Their stocks are literally trading at infinite. Like I said earlier, there's a deli in New Jersey that trades at $114 million. But you can go across the markets and look at the cash flows versus the companies. And yes, the stocks are up and through the moon, but the real economy isn't growing. And like I said, the productivity growth of the last quarter was -6.2%. Well, despite all the money printing, the system is no longer working. And so I really wanted to strongly felt that we should send a message that our system's broken.
So the way out of that, Chris, is to go back to producing the economy. And, you know, it started in the 80s with globalization and pushing out manufacturing.
100%.
And when we went to New Orleans Investment Conference, and I had that special private event after, one of the studies I did, because I was researching who are going to be our next biggest investors. You know, if you're a company and you're wanting people to invest, who's going to invest in you? And I looked at a bunch of different studies, and the Kiplinger study had the millennials as being the smartest generation because they have access to more information via this, right? So they have the means and access to information. But the one thing that Kiplinger study pointed out is exactly what you said. People aren't taking risk anymore. They want to invest in the Amazons and Tesla of the world. Well, they're actually taking risks. They just don't know that they are. But they want to invest in one end of the supply chain, the finished products. But nobody wants to invest in all the companies that manufacture, explore, find, make, develop, those types of jobs. And so I think we're sitting in this service economy with an inability to support ourselves. And the rest of the world is moving on to developing all the manufacturing capacity. And that puts us in a disadvantageous position, Chris, I think.
100%. I don't actually think people are making decisions anymore. I think, again, 60% of the market is passive. Everyone in the world is looking up and they're saying, who's buying Amazon? Who would buy that? Who would pay for that deli in New Jersey? Who would buy Tesla at $1.1 trillion when Ford trades at $80 billion and produces 10 times as many cars? And they're looking, who does that? And then I turn to them and say, just look in, do you buy index funds? Then look in the mirror. It's you that's buying them. And so what I believe has been happening is as the Fed prints money, money flows to the indexes indiscriminately and doesn't sort between winners and losers.
So exactly
the entire market goes up indiscriminately. But because everything goes up and there's no winners and losers, the real economy slows. That's the point that people don't understand. The real economy is no longer growing. So I'm trying to benefit the, I'm on the side of the 99%.
Yes.
The people who are struggling to make ends meet. And that's what this movie is about. It's basically showing a guy who's struggling to make ends meet. There's another guy in the movie who's making hundreds of millions of dollars in his new video app. And he's looking at him saying, why is this guy make so much money? And why am I struggling to make ends meet? And so we wanted to explain that to the average person.
We wanted to show that.
Correct.
The movie is about showing. I want to be very clear. It's not about exposition, about showing how this is all happening. Showing what's really beautiful about this project that I also want to include with every project that we do. It's having people. So who you don't see who's filming this event is one of our partners, Paul Speziale, who's also been in the film industry for over a decade. And one of the things that we're looking to do is combine our experience in the film world with somebody's expertise in the financial world. What Chris is saying is vital information, but what's really necessary is to show it in a way that people can start to break it down, process and retain, because it's big concepts that really need to be out there.
We actually want to change the mindset of, we want to create a debate whether markets are efficient anymore. Because I think it's pretty clear that markets are no longer efficient, no longer working for everybody. The markets aren't efficient, which is causing the real economy to slow. And I think we want to create that debate. And it's pretty clear if you look up, because we all know GameStop isn't worth $20 billion. They're bankrupt. They're a company that nobody, everyone downloads.
They're a zombie company.
It's funny how Saturday Night Live laughs at the financial professionals, right, saying that markets aren't efficient, and they're joking about every week. But if you talk to financial professionals, they're saying markets are efficient because I can't beat them. Yep. But it's not, they can't beat them because all that's happening is the Fed's printing money and money's flowing to the index. And if money flows to an index, everything goes up indiscriminately. So we're basically just showing how the system's completely broken. But the fact that it's broken is slowing the real economy, which hurts the average person.
So let's talk more about the movie. Let's talk about what details you can give on the production schedule. I know you can't divulge everything, but when is this movie coming out? When can people access it? And if they want to get involved in the movie itself, I'm an investor, by the way. I put my money where my mouth is. I pledged $25,000 to the project because I believe so much in it. And I was talking to Julian on the phone yesterday. The reason I did that, yes, as an investor, I'm in it for some return. That's what investors do. But really, the return is more the education of the market. We need to wake up the market because that's going to benefit all of us. And it's going to save so many people from financial hardship in the future. So I'm helping, the movie as much as I can. But Julian, how can people get involved? And when are you guys making it? How are they going to be able to access this movie when it comes out?
Yes, well, things are moving right along. We're about to hit December, which is a big month. This is when we not only register the entire film with the state, but the Screen Actors Guild, and we go after our big name talent. Very happy to say we got our lead protagonist and antagonist, and now we're going after, like I said, our big ticket person. In terms of shooting, we're going to be shooting this coming March 2022.
Okay.
We're looking to have the film released by the spring 2023.
Oh, that'd be awesome. That'd be perfectly timely, Julian, because I think, as I've been saying on the channel, I think that we're in the 11th hour of this iteration of the economy. And I think the film's going to come out at a critical time and explaining all the changes are going on right as it's happening.
Yes, and Robert, you just touched on the money right there. Timing. Yeah. Timing yes. is crucial, not only for us currently living in this day and age, but for the movie, for everything that the movie is discussing, that it takes place in, from when the film is released. Yes, timing is huge. And we also believe this is really one of the most important, if not the most important subjects that we feel truly everyone should know about.
We're basically trying to timestamp a currency transition, which is a massive change in everyone's life.
Oh, you will. And when the film comes out, I think, Chris, because of what's going on in the world right now, people are starting to wake up and say, hey, this isn't the system I grew up in. And you guys are going to hit people at the exact time that they've subconscious has woken up and said, there's a problem. You're going to hit them with an explanation, you know, a visual, if you will, show them what's going on. And I think it's really going to reverberate.
If inflation is higher than it is today,
yeah,
and starting to impact people's pocketbooks,
yes,
then we're going to have a massive hit. Because right now everyone's talking about inflation, but in a year, I believe that the money supplies can be a lot higher because I think the Fed has no option but to print money.
Yeah, I agree with you there. I think they're stuck between a rock and a hard place. And we're kind of in that the Austrian crack up boom part of the cycle. There's nothing they can do. The Fed can't control it anymore. So going back to this movie, there have been other movies that kind of talked about this stuff. The Big Short, Wolf of Wall Street, you know, have kind of documented in their way, you know, what goes on here. How is The Money Game different? What differentiates The Money Game versus some of those other films?
Well, this ties into one of the big things that we want to do as a team is have the real side. So again, collaborating with actual financial truths and facts with, you know, films. And as much as I really am a fan of both The Big Short and Wolf of Wall Street, no disrespect to those films, but one of the things we're looking to do is really know the subject matter that we're presenting cinematically to make sure that it comes off in a way that people not only can understand, but, you know, hopefully are able to gather something so they can implement it into their lives. Wolf of Wall Street, very entertaining film, but I will say I do not know how I can go sell penny stocks after seeing that film.
Yeah, I don't know that it provided solutions. And Julian and Chris, I think the key is here to open people's minds to what's going on so that we can have that conversation and seek alternative solutions. Because if we don't seek alternative solutions, the same thing is going to happen that happened back in 2008. A lot of people are going to get hurt. You know, and like in 2000, when I lost 40% of my portfolio due to the tech crash, and I woke up and said, no more passive investing for me. That's when I woke up. It was about 21 years ago. There's a lot of people waiting to kind of wake up and see that like I have. And we need to generate that discussion, like you said, Chris. That's what we need to do. And then the next step is, what are the solutions? How do we solve this problem?
So I think what you're seeing is a sovereign debt crisis.
Yes.
During a sovereign debt crisis, because our debt to GDP is 130%. It's never been higher, right? But during a sovereign debt crisis, what happens is the feds print money. If they print money, it's not the stocks necessarily go down, it's the currency. But when the currency falls and inflation happens, it impacts everyone. And we actually related in the movie to Germany, 1921 to 1924. If you look at a chart in Germany, 1921 to 1924, in nominal Deutschmark terms, stocks went up. They didn't go down. It was the currency that fell. And when a person's coffee went from $3 to $30, they start saying, well, why am I paying $30? Who the hell is making all that money? And the answer is the business owners at the time. And they turned that into a racist thing, which against the Jews or whatever. But once you hit that, if this movie hits during the resentment stage, that people are saying, well, why is my coffee just going from $3 to $12? All of a sudden, and people are gonna say, well, who's making all the money? It's the business owners. And look at stocks. Stocks go up, and they've been going up.
Right? And in other words, what the movie's gonna do is it's gonna provide an alternative narrative to what you're gonna see in the financial press. Because the financial press never gets it right. I mean, with all due respect to them, they don't get it right. And what we need to do is provide on a wide format people with an alternative narrative, at least to get them thinking about, okay, I'm not going to take the usual explanations here. Let's learn from history, you know, what's going on here.
Right. And another thing we're doing, Robert, is we're having this all take place through the eyes of one of the most relatable characters during the pandemic. So it's all happening right now. And what Chris is bringing up, what I'm bringing up, again, we're going to get to see it through the, one of the most relatable type of people that, again, the 99% that all of us can relate to.
That's the key. And that's what makes a great story. You know, and Ernest Hemingway wrote his books, and all those great authors write their books. They write it from the common man's perspective. That's what makes a great book. Is you're telling a story from the perspective of somebody that's looking up saying, okay, what is all of this going on? You know, and how do I understand and how do I process that? And I think that's so powerful to use that medium like some of the great authors did to tell that story. So I want to get into how do we support the movie. So I pledged 25 grand to this. It's going to come from our business. I've been blessed at Gold Silver Pros to have had the success we did that I could do that. So we're putting Gold Silver Pros behind the film. If people want to get involved, Julian, how do they do that? If they want to support this idea.
Well, I really appreciate that, your contribution and just having us on to promote it. So the best way to promote this at this point, Friday is when we're closing funds and we're moving to the next stage. But to stay in touch, I would definitely like to drop my email so people that would like to get involved can.
Okay. Yeah, we'll put links down in the description of the video how people can contact you if they want to get involved up front and they're interested in the investment thesis. Can you explain a little bit about the investment thesis now, or would you like to just reply to people as they reach out to you?
Well, I'll say this. At this point, we're very happy to say we have the money that we're going to need to shoot the film. We're now getting basically whatever funds come in now help to go to the big name actor that we get. It's very important for any film. One of the questions that's always asked is who's in the movie. So it's very important to be able to answer that, not only to get more attention so we can make this even more of a global phenomenon and make it appeal to as more of the masses.
Yeah.
But it's just very important, especially to add to a lot of the content that Chris is saying. We want, you know, a known person that really can not only sell the role, but can help the viewers just retain and get that.
So the better actor you can get, the bigger the film can be.
Yeah. So you want star power at this point. Everything's in place in terms of filming, shooting, story. All the back end stuff is there. You're just looking to upgrade, you know, and get, you know, an A-list star on the film.
And so here's how the investment works. If the budget is $1 million, the investors get 1.25 immediately before anyone else gets paid. Mm-hmm. Right? Then they own 25% of the film. Mm-hmm. So let's say it's an $11 million film. Investors put in $1 million, walk away with $3.5 million. Now, let's say inflation hits and it becomes a really big movie, say a $100 million movie. Now investors make 25x. Mm-hmm. Right? And keep in mind, our story is about how the ecosystem of capitalism has changed and capitalism is broken. That's a pretty big topic compared to Wolf of Wall Street, which is a $900 million film, which is about penny stocks.
Yeah, no, this film is going to appeal to everybody. That's why I like the film. You're not picking a specific area like the mortgage crisis or let's explain this, let's explain Lehman. Right. You're saying, let's talk about it in holistic terms. What does this really mean to anybody? And it's not limited to people in the US, by the way. I mean, people around the world can access this movie.
And notice how there's now two different economies. Mm-hmm. There's the financial economy where everything's trading infinite. Then there's the real economy, which is struggling. Mm. Right. And so we really strongly make that point visually throughout the entire movie that there's two different economies in the world now and they don't work together. It used to be in the real that things would work together. But now that the Fed intervened, the two economies no longer work together.
So, Julian, is this going into theaters? How are you guys going to release the film?
Well, that all depends on the best offer that we get from the different distribution companies that we have lined up.
Mm. Gotcha. And do you think that you'll at least have the ability to go, you know, globally with this? Because I think the topic effect, we're all global in the financial system now. There's no more US versus China. That's all a false narrative. Everybody's invested in everybody. So what makes sense for us in America is going to make sense for people in South Africa and Europe and around the world. So I think everybody needs to see this.
Well, that's why, to answer your question, our distribution plan is to get it to as many people as possible. Mm-hmm.
We were actually talking about it earlier that we're going to put it in a bunch of different languages. If it's a big hit, we're going to keep dubbing it and putting it in different languages across the world.
Yeah, awesome. I think the concept, I've actually wanted to do something like this, but the medium I had in social media was somewhat limited. I didn't have the grand sort of landscape that you do in film. And I'm so glad that you guys did. When Chris came to me, I was like, oh my God, I've been wanting to do something like this. I just didn't have you know, the expertise to do it. And I think you guys, you know, you have that. And so it's the perfect time. I mean, literally the perfect time to do the film. If you'd done it 10 years ago, it wouldn't resonate quite as much. But I think now it's going to resonate with people in a way that previously it would not have.
And never in history has the Fed increased the money supply M1 from 4 trillion to 20 trillion in 1 year.
In 1 year in result of the pandemic. Yeah. So never. Chris, to your point, we haven't even seen the big inflation yet. We're seeing the baby inflation. Mm. What could come next is going to be phenomenal. And when y'all get the film out is when that next stage is going to occur. So like I said, it's literally perfect timing. So if people are interested in seeing the film, we certainly want you to pay attention to the channel. We're going to bring more content on this movie, you know, as it's being produced on Gold Silver Pros. We're going to help continue to market the movie. So stay tuned to Gold Silver Pros for that. Also, if you guys are interested in helping the film reach, you know, its final budget objective and get that final A-list star that they want, definitely reach out to Chris and Julian. We'll have contact details below, or you can email me at Robert at Gold Silver Pros and I'll forward you over to the team. Chris, Julian, any last thoughts as we wrap up this session on the film or anything that, you know, we haven't discussed that you want to let the viewers know?
Well, we really appreciate it. And we're just excited to keep on rolling.
I just think that the timing couldn't be more better. It couldn't be better. I mean, if we can hit this, if inflation is above 12% in a year, which I think it will be, then everyone in the world is going to be talking about why are prices going up. They already are. But if in a year, and I don't think anything's going to change, if in a year inflation is starting to go out of the way and we're hit that resentment stage, then people start blaming people. Why is this happening? I don't understand what's going on. And they see the movie. This could be a blockbuster.
Which is why it just needs to come out. Going back to, you know, the basis for one of the reasons why I want to do this is for everyone, you know?
Yeah, it's not just for us. I want to make that clear. If I never see a dime of the money back, you know, I will, but I don't care. It's about the education piece. That's why that's my why. It's just educating the market. That's really why I'm in it and why I'm supporting it. So appreciate you guys coming on the channel. Stay tuned to Gold Silver Pros. Yeah, we're going to have more on this film for sure. We're going to bring Julian and Chris back on. They've been at our conference. We'll bring them on, you know, as we're making the movie. You'll see some exclusive content here on the movie that you may not see elsewhere. We'll bring that to you guys and appreciate everybody for joining us.
Thanks again, Robert.
Thank you, Robert.
Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. We appreciate it. Please remember to like, subscribe, and share, and hit that notification button so you get those notifications when new content comes out. If you like what we're doing here, please consider supporting us on Patreon. Those members of Patreon will get extra special content delivered to them as well.